Welcome everybody. So today we'll be looking at some functions in Microsoft Word that will enable you, you know, format your document. To start, I would want to input some random text here, and that would be using this formula. All right, using that formula over there, so you can work with me actually on this. So I will now press the enter key. So you can see here I have this random text inside this document. So the first thing I want to look at is the hide and show. The hide and show, to assess that, the home tab over there, the paragraph group, and if you look upwards in the ribbon, you will see that symbol show and hide. So this show and hide, if I click on it, you will see the symbol over there, that sign there that comes out. It simply indicates that each of these are paragraphs. You can see we have one paragraph, two, three, four, and five. So here, if I'm to type in anything at that point, then that's a different paragraph at that point. So it indicates, the hide and show shows you how many paragraphs, gives you an indication of how many paragraphs you have in your document. The next thing the hide and show does is to tell you how many spaces you have in each word, or in each word. You can see this point, this dot where we have video and the dots there. Those dots tells you that those are spaces, one space before you have another word. So if I go back and click on that hide and show, or the show slash hide, you can see I've taken off those dots. For you to understand what I really mean, if I put in more spaces here, right now, if I go ahead and click on the hide and show, home tab, paragraph group, and the show hide, so at this point you can see it's now showing me that I have more than one spacing. You can see that several dots over there. That is an indication that I have more than one spacing. So with a hide and show, or show hide symbol or formula, I can easily pinpoint where I have an issue in my document and just correct it. So now I can just press backspace and put a normal space there, which is just one dot. All right, so the hide and show button enables us to see what our document looks like and correct it, and we can then correct it. All right, so I'll just take that off. The next thing I want to look at is the tabs. So if I click here and press the enter key, so I have a space there, right? So the normal tabs we know is on the keyboard. When we press tab, I can just press tabs. That's the default tab that we have. But the thing is, we can actually customize our tab. If I take it backwards, we can customize our tabs. Look up here where we have the ruler below the ribbon. So if I look under by the left hand side, top there, below the ribbon, you will see that symbol there showing me right tab. Yeah, so from there, with that, we can customize our tabs. So if I click on that, it says right tab, but I want to use, if I click on it, it gives me different kinds of tabs. So I'm looking for the center tab. So that's my center tab. You can see it's an upside down T formula over there. So I just want you to see what it looks like. That's my center tab. So if I click on that center tab and come here and locate the center just after 7 and click there, now I have a center tab. So I can type in something here where I have the left tab, which is the default tab. I can type in name and press the tab key. It goes straight out. You can see where I have the custom center tab. Now I can type in campus, All right. So I want to put a right tab. I go back to that top left hand corner. Click so I can get a right tab. What is this one? That's my right tab. You can see what it looks like over there. That's my right tab. So if I click on that right tab, go ahead and click somewhere in the ruler here by the 14. Now I have placed the right tab there. So if I press my key, tab key here on the keyboard, I can type in student name and press the enter key. So now the tab actually allows you to align things nice and neat. So by this I can put in my student's name, press the tab key, put in the campus, and put in student's number, the same thing, right? So this tab actually works like table. Let's say you assume you don't want to use a table, you want to use a tab. You can use this as your table, kind of, to align things nice and good. All right, so we are done with the tabs. So the next thing I want to look at is the indentation. Now we have first paragraph here. You can just click on the first paragraph to apply an indentation, or you select it, but let's just click on it. So to apply indentation, you go to the home tab, go to the paragraph group over there, and you click by the dialog box launcher. So if I click on the dialog box launcher, I would have this dialog box appear for me. So what I'm looking at now is the indentation, not here, not this one that says general. I'm not going there. What I'm looking at here is the indentation. You can see left is 0 centimeter, right is 0 centimeter. What I'm looking at now is the special. So if I click this down arrow button where I have the special box, click that down arrow arrow there, and I want to choose the first line indentation. So if I click on the first line indentation, and where I have the by box over there, okay, I want to make it 1.2 centimeter. So now I have 1.2 centimeter by box, and it's first line indentation. All right, so now if I click on, you can see the preview here, what it looks like. This is the first line indentation. So if I click OK, you can see over here that my paragraph has been aligned by first line indentation. It's formatted. The first paragraph is now formatted first line indentation. Okay, so if I go to the, let's call this our third paragraph. If I go to the third paragraph now, what I want to apply here is hanging indent or hanging indentation. So if I click on the third paragraph over there and I go back to my home tab, paragraph group, and click on the dialog box launcher, I would go back the same place, go back to my indentation, and where I have the special, choose and use, click on the hanging. Then this time I want to align it by 2 centimeter. You can see what I have there, 2 centimeter. All right. So why I did that, you can see the preview of what my document looked like, or what that particular paragraph looks like. So if I click OK, you can see this is my hanging indentation, and the first paragraph is first line indent. You can see the different formats. All right, so we can also work on paragraph indentation. We can apply indent to paragraph. So on this fourth paragraph, click on it anywhere, and let's go to the layout tab. If you click on the layout tab, you go to the paragraph group over there, and you can see the indent, left indent and right indent. Now let's apply 2 centimeter each for left indent, and apply 2 centimeter for right indent. You can see there indent 2, left 2, right 2 centimeter. Okay, so you can see over here, look at my fourth paragraph, what it has turned to. You can further make it say 1 centimeter each. Let me just quickly do that. 1 centimeter, give a space, and say 1 centimeter and press the enter key. Okay, so this looks a little bit fine. So you can see we have, if successfully indented this paragraph to 1 centimeter left and 1 centimeter right. All right, you can apply spacing to your document before and after spacing. When you're working on your paragraph, you want to, you know, put some nice formatting in your work doc, in your assignment or your document, so it looks really nice and professional. So let's format this fifth paragraph by applying spacing to the paragraph. So if you look over here, the layout tab, we have the paragraph group, and we have over here the spacing. We have before spacing. So while my cursor is on the fifth paragraph, rather, before spacing, I want to increase before spacing. You can see how that is moving. So before spacing, before this particular paragraph, what kind of space do you want to leave there? So that's what it means. Then after that paragraph, what is the space? What space points do you want to leave? So still at that point, after the paragraph, how do you want it? You can see how it's moving. So that's what it means when you have before and after spacing. What kind of, do you want a large space before your each paragraphs, or you want a small space? So that's where you align spaces. Good. So I will just scroll down a little bit and go to, say, at this point, I'll press down my stuff. I want to work on test wrapping, and I want to use a picture to do that. So I will just quickly go to the insert tab over there. I want to import a picture. I go to the pictures, and I have this particular one, and I insert it. Now this is a picture that I have here. If I want to move this picture around, I can't. If I click on it and I want to move it around, you can see I really cannot do that. But for me to be able to do this, I can apply test wrapping to it. You can see by the left top here, right hand corner, you can see the layout option. So if I click on that layout option here, I have some options here. I can choose this particular one in front of test, or I can use this one, square. If I click on this particular one that says square, now let's see if I can move this test around. You can see I can easily move my test to anywhere. All right, so I want to resize this picture actually. So I clicked on that picture. I can go ahead from here and resize it. But if you really want to work with size, it's easier for you to click on that picture and go to where you have size group and type in what size immediately you want to put it. Let's make it 5 centimeter and press the enter key. So I have this as my 5 centimeter. I can move this test or that picture to wherever I want it to be. You can see square. So you can see why I move this picture. The test adjusts to the picture nicely. So now I have successfully moved this picture upwards to my second paragraph. But you can notice here that the test, you know, fits in closely to that picture. That's what test wrapping is. All you need to do is click by this symbol here, layouts option, and choose the exact one you want to work with. If you want to work with the square, you click on the square and you're able to move your pictures or logo around your test. Or any, you can say in front of test, the same thing, you'll be able to move your picture around your test. So that brings us to the end of this tutorial. I hope you like it, and I hope you find this very interesting and useful. If you did, kindly click the like button and I will see you again in the next video.